Well, good morning, everybody. It's Friday, December 17th, and we are now entering the final weekend before Christmas. I know you've got a lot to do. I do, too. But I want to encourage you. Make Sunday morning at E-Free a priority. This Sunday, we continue our series, An Epic Christmas, and we see the epic gift. You don't want to miss it, 9 o'clock and 10:30. And mark it on your calendar, Christmas Eve. You can watch us live online, 4 o'clock and 6 o'clock. Now, all week, we talked in the Christmas story about the angels and the shepherds. The shepherds went to the manger, they've left. What happened next in the Christmas story? Well, most people think the wise men showed up. Wrong. That's not what happened next. In fact, quite a bit of time will pass before the wise men get there. You know what happens next chronologically in the Bible? Jesus is presented in the temple. Now let me read about it. Luke 2, I'm going to read verses 21 through 24. And when 8 days had passed, 8 days from what? The birth of Jesus. So at least 8 days passed. Wise men haven't showed up yet. They did not come to the manger. Before his circumcision, which would happen on the 8th day, his name was called Jesus, the name given by the angel before he was conceived in the womb. And when the days for their purification, according to the law of Moses, were completed, they brought him up to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord, as it is written in the law of the Lord, every firstborn male that opens the womb shall be called holy to the Lord, and to offer a sacrifice according to what was said in the law of the Lord. And notice the sacrifice they offered, a pair of turtle doves or 2 young pigeons. Now, when we talk about Joseph early in our check-ins, we talk about how he was a man who obeyed God. So notice 3 ways that Mary and Joseph obey God in what I just read to you. Number 1, they had him circumcised. Every Jewish male was to be circumcised on the 8th day. That's seen in Leviticus chapter 12. 8 days passed, wise men haven't shown up yet. Jesus is circumcised according to the law. Then they named him Jesus. And by the way, you waited until the 8th day, you waited until the circumcision to give your child the name. They name him Jesus. Why? Because in Luke 1, that's exactly what the angel said to Mary. You'll conceive in your womb, you'll bear a son, you'll name him Jesus. In Matthew 1, that's what the angel said to Joseph in the dream. She will bear a son, you will call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. Then, when the time of purification had passed, that was a good 40 days, when Mary's purification is now over, they now bring Jesus to the temple. By the way, the wise men still haven't shown up yet. They did not come to the manger. They present him to God with an offering. That's what you were to do according to Leviticus chapter 12. You're to present your firstborn child to the Lord and make an offering. Now, you were supposed to offer a lamb. But lamb, as is the case today, was expensive. And there were a lot of people who couldn't afford it, including Mary and Joseph. Remember what Mary and Joseph offered? Birds. You know why? Because in Leviticus 12:9 it says this. If you cannot afford a lamb, then take 2 turtle doves or 2 young pigeons, use them for the offerings. So what do we learn about Joseph and Mary? Number 1, they were committed to obeying God. But number 2, they were very poor. You know what that tells me? The wise men hadn't shown up yet. Why? Because what gifts did the wise men bring? Gold, frankincense, myrrh. You think they could have afforded a lamb with those gifts? Sure. The wise men were not at the manger. Joseph and Mary's obedience should be the example for us to follow. Let me pray. So, Father, may we be like Joseph and Mary. No matter what our economic status is, may we obey you with all of our heart. And I pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Now, Monday, we're going to continue the Christmas story, and we're going to see some remarkable things that happen while they're at the temple. You don't want to miss it. Have a great weekend. We'll see you Sunday for church and Monday morning for our morning check-in.